JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 27th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against the majority of the other G10 currencies. It gained versus JPY, CHF, the Euro, NOK, SEK, and the British pound in that order, while it lost ground against the Canadian dollar, the Aussie, and the Kiwi. The strengthening of the commodity-linked loonie, Aussie, and Kiwi, combined with the weakness in the safe havens yen and franc, suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze in the equity world, we see that major EU and US indices closed in the positive territory, with the only exception being the Dow Jones, which slid 0.18%. That said, risk appetite eased during the Asian session today, with both Japan's Nikkei and China Shanghai composites sliding 0.42 and 0.08% respectively. It seems that the vaccination progress around the world has been keeping investors interested in increasing their risk exposures on signs of several nations reopening their economies. The fact that several major central banks are willing to keep their monetary policy extra loose for long is also providing support to equity markets. In the US, Nasdaq was the main gainer, fueled by a 1.3% advance in Tesla ahead of the firm's earnings report, which kicked off this week's results after the closing bell, on expectations that the company will report a rise in first quarter revenue, something indeed. The overall optimism faded during the Asian session today, perhaps as investors turned cautious ahead of the Fed's today monetary policy meeting, which starts today. Overall, we expect the Fed to maintain its dovish stance, with Fed Chief Powell repeating that any spikes in inflation this year are likely to prove to be temporary and that it is too early to start discussing policy normalization. Therefore, even if equities correct lower ahead of the decision, we expect them to rebound again in the aftermath and head for new record highs. Risk-linked currencies like the Aussie and the Kiwi may strengthen as well, while the US dollar and other safe havens like the yen are likely to come under renewed selling interest. Now, ahead of the Fed decision, during the Asian morning Wednesday, we get Australia's CPIs for the first quarter. The headline rate is forecast to have risen to 1.4% year-over-year from 0.9%, but the trimmed mean rate is expected to have stayed unchanged at 1.2%. Although RBA officials have been repeatedly noting that the economic recovery in Australia is well underway and stronger than previously expected, with both inflation rates staying well below the lower end of their 2-3% target range, we don't believe that they will start thinking normalization anytime soon. That said, maintaining their optimism with regards to the economy and feeling content with the Aussie's trading levels means that they are unlikely to ease policy further either. Thus, the faith of the risk-linked Aussie will probably depend more on developments surrounding the broader market sentiment and perhaps any Chinese data like the PMIs on Friday, as Australia has very close trading ties with the world's second largest economy. Now, as for today's events, during the Asian session today, we already got a Bank of Japan decision, but the outcome was broadly as expected. The bank kept its policy settings unchanged, revising up its growth forecast, but downgrading its inflation ones. Given that this was a base case scenario, the yen and Japanese equities did not react on the decision. Later in the day, the only releases worth mentioning are the US Conference Board Consumer Confidence Index for April and the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week. The CB index is expected to have risen to 113 from 109.7, while, as it is always the case, no forecasts available for the API report. As for the speakers, we have only one on today's agenda, and this is Bank of Canada Governor Tiff Macklem. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day. And I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.